First of all, thank you Lord, umabot ako dito. Nang hindi ako mahagulgol. I want to thank you Lord, Jesus Christ, for this day that He had made. Thank you God for allowing me to fall in love with such an amazing woman. But to fall in love with her, not once, not twice, but 3 times over this last time. The first time that I met her, Smithy, 2007. I remember that joy I had whenever I'm with her and just wanting to be with her all the time. Whether it be carrying her bag in our out of the country tapings dahil sobrang bigat mag-impake ni Tita, or paglalagay ng band-aid sa sugat na mas maliit pa sa langgam para lang magkaroon tayo ng moment together. At para lang mapakita ko sa'yo na love kita. We were 9, 10 years old back then. Pero kahit sobrang taray mo sa akin, dinadalahan ko pa rin siya ng cream puff habang umuulan dahil alam kong paborito niya ito. I didn't knew it back then. But looking back, it was definitely more than just a crush. The second time was in 2018 when God gave us a chance to be in a relationship. That's when I met the different side of Mariko. The compassionate, kind, and loving Mariko. We had the same goals, same perspective in life. We were a perfect match in every way. But there was one thing we were missing. We love each other so much, actually too much. We forgot to put God at the center of our relationship. We were trying to navigate our lives with our own wisdom, not seeking His guidance, and slowly, simple conversations turned into misunderstandings that became problems, and problems became too big to fix. I remember seeing you back then and just wanting to take away the pain that you were experiencing. Kung pwede lang ako na lang yung nasasaktan. With all my might, I tried to make you happy. And I failed. And that's when I prayed. The prayer. The Lord, I tried everything. I tried it my way. You know I love her, Lord. Pero kung hindi kami para sa isa't isa, then your will be done po. But please, padahanin mo sa kanya dahil hindi ko kaya makipag-hiwalay sa kanya. And then, 3 days later, she broke up with me. I think it was one of the most painful things I have experienced. I didn't understand back then why, but I just know that God answered my prayer. And I knew that God was real. He is real. And I held on to His word, Jeremiah 29:11, for I have plans for you, plans to prosper you, not to harm you, plans to give you a future and a hope. And so word in Matthew 6:33, seek ye first the kingdom of God and His righteousness, and all these things shall be added unto you. Yun lang yung pinanghawakan ko. A few months had passed, and I saw how God moved in her life, and how she accepted Jesus. Specifically remember seeing from afar how joyful she was once again, seeing that smile on her face that I haven't seen in a long time. That joy that for the longest time I've been trying to provide, but failed to do so. Kasi yung joy na yun, si Lord ay makakapagbigay. Sabi ko, ito na ata talaga yun, Lord. Siguro ito lang yung will mo for us. And I will submit to it. I wouldn't take it any other way. Na makita kitang masaya. Finally, even wala ako, pero kung ito yung will mo, I love. Makita ko lang siyang masaya. But God had other plans. As I've said, as He said in His word, plans to give us a hope and a future. He is faithful. He is. He's just. If we just obey, He will give us everything. And now He gives me my everything. He was the one who eventually brought us back together. I thank you, Lord. Thank you for everything. And to you, my love, I will not promise all the things of the world, for we will leave it here. I will not promise you riches, for they will fade, but I will promise you this. I will promise you joy, even through suffering. I will promise you peace in all circumstances. And I will promise to always point you back to Him whenever it seems so hard. And I promise to love you even when you don't anymore. Because that's how He loved me. I love you. And I can't wait to be asked back. Thank you, Lord.
Hi, Nashiko. I guess my heart always knew that one day I would end up marrying you. And I still can't believe that day has finally come. God allowed our paths to cross May of 2007. Parehas tayo nung vows eh. Sa lahat, actually. Okay, makikita mo. And here we are, May 2024, 17 years later. About to become one. I can't thank God enough that it is your name He wrote beside mine. At sobrang nagpapasalamat ako sa haba ng oras na ibinigay niya sa ating dalawa. Sobrang bait ni Lord love that He wanted na magkasama na tayong lumaki. Na andoon ka at ang pamilya mo para sumuporta sa lahat ng mga masasakit na nangyari sa pamilya namin. Na maabutan mo pa at makilala si Kuya Edward at ang daddy ko amang nandito pa sila. Na makita ko ang bawat face sa buhay ng Nash Aguas. I witnessed your skater boy face, Justin Bieber hair face, chubby cheeks face, going bulilit games team captain na napaka-competitive face, moose gear face, director and best actor face. Syempre, there was even a face where I saw you at your lowest. But I want to tell you that this Nash with me today is my favorite face of all. And that is because Jesus is glowing within you, my love. You remind me of His love and His compassion. You extend His grace and His patience to me and everyone around you. You uplift me with your presence and with your words, just like He does to the both of us each and every day. You are the most beautiful person to me inside and out because you exude His gentle spirit and the pureness of His heart. I admire you for being so strong for the both of us when we entered our pruning season August last year. I know how painful it was for me. But I can't even begin to imagine how painful and heartbreaking it was for you. But still, you obeyed when God asked you to surrender and put our relationship aside to seek Him first. I am so proud of you because it's never easy to choose the narrow path and painful path, but you did. And now we're here. Both in Christ, both of our lives and characters changed for the better. All because you chose to follow Jesus. Thank you, my love, because that decision led me straight to Him when I needed it the most. Ang galing mo nga eh, kasi hindi pa tayo Mr. and Mrs. nun, pero you were already leading me. Kaya I'm sure you'll be the best leader to our future family, future kids. Mahal na kita. Nung binubuhat mo yung bag ko, again, sa kabahan ng Great Wall of China at sa Asian Cruise ng Bulilit kahit napakabigat ng dala ko. Pati nung binilahan mo ako ng Green Mermaid Ball Pen sa Singapore, nagde-taping tayo nun. Pagkatapos mo nakita na hindi ko na binili kasi ubos na yung baon ko. Yun nga lang, sa sobrang hiya mo, medyo hinagis mo na yung mermaid ball pen na yun sa akin. So hindi na siya sweet. Kilig na kilig ako nung dinilahan mo ko ng cream puff sa bahay ni ate. At naalala ko nung basang-basa ka sa ulan. Mas madaling araw ka. Ayaw mo mag-doorbell. Ando ka na sa labas. Pasensya na rin kung hindi ko agad nasuot yung binigay mong hot pink na Candy's jacket. Alam ko nagtampo ka na ng ilang taon. Napakahabang taon bago ko siya nasuot. I love. Salamat sa lahat. At sa hinaba-haba. Ikaw ang unang crush ko. At ang huling mahal ko. I love you, love. So much. This is the start of our life together. Our forever. And I'm so blessed to be your Mrs. Victoriano.